my Harry Potter books. This here is my Harry Potter books in French. I just put them in the back because I don't have a lot of room. This is my three little Harry Potter books. And I read a few of them, but I haven't really had the chance to read them all. Then these are like my favorite series from my childhood. It's Jenny and the Cat Club. And I just have all of those books. And here I have this chicken soup for my cat's life, because when I was younger I really wanted a cat and I never got one. And then I have my babysitter's manual, because or else I'd lose it. And then I have my chemistry book. A wink.
A wink.
And then I have these three French books by Catherine Girard-Audet. They're all pretty old. And then I have all my National Geographic kids books. And then I have my two science-y books to kind of tie in with this theme. So I have my Elements book, which is really fun to flip through and just like read a page. Then I have this one that I got when I was like fourth or fifth grade, because I was obsessed with like knowing everything. And I just read it for fun. Then I have my Canadian life-saving guide, because you need it to take Bronze Medallion, Bronze Cross and stuff. And then I have my Percy Jackson Greek Gods, which is like the best big book ever. I love it. And then I have Oceanology, which is just a randomology book. So here I have Ever After High, three books, and they're just really, really pretty covers. Like every book has a really pretty cover, and they're hard covers, so I love them. And then these two books, The Boy Project and The Boy Problem. The Boy Project is the best one, it's the first one too. And they're really funny. And then I have Wonder, and this is one of the best like kids books that I've read. And I really, really, really like it. And then I have this. And these books I read last summer. It's really for kids, but I read it because I'm cool like that. It's really good. I really like them a lot. They're really short, so I just read them in the plane. And then I have this series, and currently Rebecca has my 13 gifts, but I actually really love the 11th birthday series. And then I have The Land of Stories, and I'm gonna get the third book soon. I don't have it yet, it's because I don't have it at the moment, but I'm going to get it. And I have The Princess Plot, and there's the Giver series. I only read the first book. And then there's Divergent, The Initiate's World. Yeah, it's just like a movie guide that has lots of pictures from the movie, and it's really, really quick to read. I read it in like 30 minutes. Then there's Meant to Be. It's just a random chick flick looking kind of book. I haven't read it yet, but it's on my TBR list. And then I have Since You've Been Gone, and it kind of doesn't barely fit, and I want to read this book. And then there's my Rick Riordan books. All of these books, like up till here, are Rick Riordan. So I have the Percy Jackson series, the Heroes of Olympus series, the King Chronicles, which I haven't read yet, but I will get to soon, I think. And there's the King Chronicles Survival Guide, because I needed it. And then there's the three Percy Jackson kind of companion-ish books. And then there's Throne of Glass. I haven't read it yet, but I will read it. And then there's Cinder, which I do have a book talk on. Yeah,
check it out.
I can say that now. It's really cool. And then there's Never Fade. It's the second book in The Darkest Minds. And The Darkest Minds isn't there because I'm currently reading it. And then there's the Maze Runner series. And I'm missing Scorch Trials because Dominique has it and she hasn't given it back to me yet. Because
she doesn't want to read it.
Yeah, and she doesn't want to give it back either. Which is really frustrating. Then I had the Iron Trial, and I got the really suckish paperback version with like Bible thin pages and tiny words, but I still really, really like that book. And there's Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe, and I'm going to get to reading that soon. I've heard really good things about it. On my top shelf, I have Emerald Green, which is the third book in the Ruby Red series. I don't have the second or the first book, and now it's alone on my shelf. It's really sad. And then I have The Jewel. And then I have The Young Elites. It's the first book in a new trilogy by Mary Lou. I'm super excited about it because I read the Legend series. Even though I don't have it, I read it. And they were very good. And then I have the Delirium series, Panic. Just the dust cover though, because Jody has the book. And yeah, I want my book back. And then I have I Was Here dust cover because Dominic has I Was Here. But that's where it would go if it was like there. And then I have Where Beauty Lies by Ellen Blair Fowler. And I'm gonna get the first one soon from Julie. And then I have If I Stay and Where She Went. And I haven't read this yet, but I have read this. And then I have all my John Green books. I don't have Looking for Alaska. I don't think I'm gonna get it, I don't know. And then I have the Stephanie Perkins like series, but Anna and the French Kiss, I lent it out to my friend and she still has it. She finished it, but she just hasn't given it back to me yet. Then I have I'll Give You the Sun, which is on my TBR list. I'm gonna read it soon. And then I have We Should Hang Out Sometime, which I read and it was really funny. And then I have Eleanor and Park, which I read also this year and it was pretty good. And I have Fangirl, which I gave to Julie, the one filming.
Yeah.
And she still has it. And
I'm going to give it back because it was boring.
It's not boring. It's like my favorite book ever. And then I have Rebel Belle, which I read during the Christmas break and it was really good. And I have The Duff.
Which recently came out in the theaters.
Yeah. I haven't seen the movie yet.
I didn't see it either.
But I read the book, and the book was really good. It was a bit weird. And then I have Autumn Falls, which is Bella Thorne's book, and I just kind of got it because it was pretty and because it was short, and I thought, why not? Okay, and here is my overflow section because I'm going to get a new bookshelf soon. I have a bunch of other books that aren't on my shelf right now and that are just like upstairs in my attic because I don't have room for them. But here's my overflow that I absolutely needed on my shelf. So here I have The Fifth Wave. And I read that. I'm gonna get The Infinite Sea soon, but it was really good. And then I have Days of Blood and Starlight because it's hardcover and it was on sale for $5. And I'm just like, I'm gonna read this series at some point, so why not get the second book? And I still need to get the first book, and I will get it. And then I have the Bookshop Chronicles, the first three books in like this one big book, kind of like a historical fiction book. And I read like a bit of the first book, but I haven't really continued it. Then I have Lock and Key by Sarah Dessen, another book by Sarah Dessen, What Happened to Goodbye. Then I have this book, Don't You Wish, The Secret Ingredient, which I'm currently reading. That's why it's not really there. To All the Boys I've Loved Before, which Jackie has, so it's not there. Popular, which Marjorie has, which is not there. And then I have The Summer I Turned Pretty, which I'm going to read soon because it's by the same author as this book, and I really like this book. So I think I'm gonna like this book too. And then here is like a DIY TBR list with like a to buy list. So on top here I have my to be read books, which this is like my list. And all these books I own already. And then on my to buy list is all the books I want to read that I don't have yet that I wanna have, that I need to have. And how I made this is I got a frame at the dollar store, I painted it silver, and then there was like a line here and a line here, like as you can see like the rip marks, and I kind of just took those off, and it's supposed to be for like four pictures, but not anymore. And then I put some colorful paper in the back, I put some like normal paper on top so that you could see what I wrote with my marker, and I decorated my marker with washi tape and gem stickers. It's really pretty. For this wall, I went on Pinterest and I found a bunch of book-related quotes that I liked. I printed them out and I decorated the borders with some washi tape, and it looks really cute on the side of my bookshelf, just kind of like a little pop. I'll be down, not forever, just for now.